गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ चैप्टर 2 लीनियर इक्वेशन इन वन वेरिएबल्स एक्सरसाइज 2.4 क्वेश्चन नंबर 5। क्वेश्चन 5 है शोभो मदर्स प्रेजेंट एज इज 6 टाइम्स शोभो प्रेजेंट एज। शोभो एज 5 इयर्स फ्रॉम नाउ विल बी 1/3 ऑफ हिज मदर्स प्रेजेंट एज। व्हाट आर देयर प्रेजेंट एज? सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन शोभो मदर्स एज इज 6 टाइम्स द शोभो प्रेजेंट एज। शोभो मदर्स प्रेजेंट एज इज 6 टाइम्स द शोभो प्रेजेंट एज। इफ वी लेट द शोभो प्रेजेंट एज इज एक्स देन हिज मदर्स एज बी 6x। ओके, नाउ अगेन वंस कंडीशन इज गिवेन इन दिस क्वेश्चन दैट शोभो एज 5 ईयर्स फ्रॉम नाउ मीन्स आफ्टर 5 ईयर्स विल बी 1/3 ऑफ हिज प्रेजेंट एज ऑफ मदर्स। इट मीन्स दैट इफ वी लेट द शोभो एज प्रेजेंट एज इज एक्स आफ्टर 5 ईयर्स शोभो प्रेजेंट एज विल बी एक्स प्लस 5। बट what is the present age of Shobha mother? This is 6 times of Shobha age present age. So Shobha mother's present age is 6x. Okay, so after 5 years, whose age after 5 years? Shobha mother's age after 5 years, Shobha age after 5 years is x plus 5. This is equal to 1/3. Shobha mother's age means 1/3 6 1/3 into 6x. Okay, so let's see how to solve these questions. So first we let Shobha present age. Let Shobha's present age be x and Shobha present age be x and what is the Shobha mother's present age? 6 times of Shobha age, so it's equal to 6x years. Okay, so you can write here Shobha mother's Shobha mother's present age is equal to what? 6 times of Shobha present age. This is equal to 6x years. Okay, now what is the age of Shobha after 5 years? Okay, so age of Shobha after 5 years is equal to, you can write here age of Shobha after 5 years. After 5 years is equal to after 5 years. Okay, this is equal to x plus 5. Age of Shobha's after 5 years is equal to x plus 5. This is equal to and will be 1/3. This is this age is the 1/3 of his mother. His mother's present age. So mother present age is 6x. And the Shobha age after 5 years is x plus 5. So this is equal to 1/3 of the mother's present age. Okay, so now we write here according to question. Okay, according to question we have x plus 5, this is the age of Shobha after 5 years, this is equal to 1/3 into 1/3 of the present age of mother. So what is the present age of mother? You can see here, this is 6x, this is equal to 6x. Okay, so you can cancel it, 3 1 3 3 2 6, and you can write here x plus 5, this is equal to 2x, or you can write here 2x minus x, this is equal to 5. Or you can see here, and this implies that x is equal to, what is x? X is equal to 5. So what is x? X is the present age of Shobhu. Okay, x is the present age of Shobhu. So you can say the hence the present age of Shobhu is equal to 5 years, and the present age of Shobhu mothers is equal to 30 years. Okay, so you can write here in this question. Okay, first we let present age of Shobhu, let Shobhu's present age be x, and this is given that the present age of Shobhu is 6 times of Shobhu's present age, this is 6 years, and also given the age of Shobhu after 5 years, this is equal to x plus 5, and the age of suppose after 5 years, this is equal to 1/3 of the present age of Shobhu mothers. So here according to condition, you can see here x plus 5 is equal to 1/3 into 6x. If you cancel it, then you have 2x. X plus 5 is equal to 2x, or you can see 2x minus 1 is 2x minus x is equal to 5, or x is equal to 5. So what is x? X is the Shobhu present age. So you can write here, Shobhu present age is equal to, what is the Shobhu present age? Shobhu present age is equal to, Shobhu present age is equal to, you can write here 5 here. Okay, and Shobhu mother present age is equal to, what is the Shobhu mother present age? This is equal to 6. So you can write here 6 into 5, this is equal to 30 years. So student, I hope all have understood this question, that how to find this question. Here in this question, this is given, Shobhu mother present age is the 6 times of the Shobhu present age. And also this is given, the after 5 years, Shobhu age will be 1/3 of the mother's present age. Okay, so in this way, we find the value of x is equal to 5, and this is a Shobhu present age. Clear? And the Shobhu mother present age is 6 into 5 is 30 years. Okay, so I hope all of you understood this question. Okay, now we are going to discuss next question, question number 6. This question is given that there is a narrow rectangular plot reserved for a school in a Mahulik village. Okay, there is a rectangular plot reserved for a school in a Mahuli village. The length and the breadth of the plot are in the ratio 11:4, and at the rate 100 per meter, it will be cost the village panchayat is 75,000 to fence the plot. What are the dimensions of the plot? Okay, so here rate of fence given 100 rupees per meter. Okay, and the cost of fencing is also given 75,000. Okay, so we need to find here the length and the breadth of the plot. Okay, so first we find the area. Okay, so in this question, the length ratio of length and the breadth is given. Okay, 11:4. So we let length is 11x and the breadth is 4x. Okay, after this we find the perimeter of the plot. How you find the perimeter of the plot? Because here given the cost of fencing per meters and the total cost of the fencing of the plot is given. So we find perimeter of the plot is equal to total cost by cost of 1 meter. So here total cost is given 75,000, and cost of 1 meter is equal to 100 rupees. So if we divide 75,000 by 100, then we obtain 750 meters. Okay, so and this is the shape of rectangle. So we know that the perimeter of rectangle is equal to length into breadth. So we put length is 4x and the breadth is, length is 11x and the breadth is 4x. And this is equal to 750, and you can find the value of x here. The value of x is equal to 25, and put the value of x in length is 11x, so say length is equal to 11 into 25 and the breadth is 4x and this is equal to 4 into 25. So let's see how to solve these questions. Okay, so first we erase this question, and in this question number 6 we should give them a rectangular plot. Okay, in Mahauli village. So rectangular plot, you can see this is question number 6. Okay, and this is a rectangular plot, this is given. Okay, and the ratio of length into breadth is given. Ratio of length and breadth is given here 11 and ratio 4. Okay, 11 ratio 4, this is given, this is a length and the breadth. So you let length be at 11x and the breadth be 4x. Okay, now let length of the plot, plot means rectangular plot, this is the 11x and breadth of the plot, breadth of the plot is 4x. Okay, so you can write here this is 11x and this is 4x. Rectangular. Okay, and here also given cost of fencing per meter is 100 rupees. What is given? Cost of fencing. Cost of fencing is here given. Cost of fencing per meter, this is given here. Fencing per meter, this is given here, rupees 100. Okay, and total cost of fence. Total cost of fence. Okay, this is also given 75,000. Okay, so we need to find the perimeter of the plot. Okay, total cost of fencing. First, you find the total cost of fencing. This is equal to rupees 75,000. Okay, this is a given total cost of fencing, rupees 75,000. Now you need to find the perimeter of plot. So how you find perimeter of plot? Perimeter of plot is equal to cost of fencing, total cost by cost per meter, cost 1 per meter. Okay, so here total cost is given 75,000 and cost per meter is 100. Here you can see, so if you can see, then you obtain 750 meter. Okay, in this way you find the perimeter of a rectangular plot. This is equal to 750 meters. Okay, but you know the perimeter of rectangular plot is equal to 2 into length plus breadth. Okay, this is equal to perimeter. So in this question we let length is equal to 11x and the breadth is equal to 4x. Okay, so if you put the value of 11x, you replace L by 11x and B by 4x, then you obtain 2 into 11x plus 4x is equal to perimeters of the rectangular plot 750. Okay, so let's see how to find its perimeters. Here we find 16 meter. How to find the length and the breadth of the rectangular plot? Okay. Now first we ready. So here, this is equal to 2 into length plus breadth. This is perimeter of rectangular plot. And here we obtain perimeter is equal to 750 meters. And the equivalent length is 11x and the breadth is 4x, because this is given. The ratio of length and the breadth is 11:4. This is equal to 75. 750. Okay. Now, if you divide here, 2 into 11x plus 4x, this is equal to 15x. This is equal to 75. 15 to the 30, 750. 15 to the 30x, this is equal to 750. Or you can write here 750 by 30. So, 0 can see. Or you can write x is equal to what? 25. X is equal to 25. So what is x? We let the length is 11x and the breadth is 4x. Okay. So here we need to find length of rectangular plot. So length of rectangular plot is equal to, we can write here. Length of a rectangular plot, this is equal to, we let here this is 11x, but the value of x is 25, so 11 into 25, this is equal to what? 11 on the 11, 11 5 is 55, 11 2 is 22 plus 5, 27. Meters. Okay, so you can see here the length of the rectangular plot is 275 meters. Now we need to find the breadth of the rectangular plot. Breadth of a rectangular plot is breadth of rectangular plot is equal to 4x, we let, but the value of x is, we find 25, so 4 into 25 is equal to 100 meters. Okay, so I hope all of you understood this question, how to solve. In these questions, and this is given that the rectangular plot of length and breadth ratio is 11 and ratio 4, and rate of fencing is 100 rupees per meter, and the cost of fencing is given 75,000 rupees. Okay, and the question asks to find the dimension of the rectangular plots. Okay, so first we let, because here the given the ratio and ratio of length and the breadth of rectangular plot is 11:4. 11:4 is given here. Okay, so first we let length of the rectangular plot is x. 11x, length of rectangular plot is 11x, and the breadth of rectangular plot is 4x. Okay, now after this we find the perimeter of rectangular plot. How you find the perimeter of rectangular plot? Because here given the total cost of fencing and the rate of fencing is also given. Okay, so you find perimeter of rectangular plot is equal to total cost of fencing by rate of fencing. The total cost of fencing is given here 75,000 by 100. Okay, so in this way you find the perimeter of rectangular plot. And but we know that the perimeter of rectangular plot is 2 into L plus B. Length is here we let 11x, and the breadth is also we let 4x. So we put the value of length and the breadth in the formula. Perimeter is equal to 2 into L plus B. This is equal to, we find a perimeter 750. Okay, after putting the value of ln to be, then we obtain 15 into 2x. This is equal to 30x is equal to 750. 30x is equal to 750. If you divide 750 by 30, you can see here. This is L, this is B. L is 11x, B is 4x. And if you plus them, you obtain 15x. And here into 2, this is equal to 30x. And here 750, we write as it is. When you divide 750 by 30, then you obtain 25 is the value of x. Okay, so in this way you find the length of the rectangular part. What is the length of the rectangular part? Here we let the rectangular part, length of rectangular part to be 11x. So this is equal to 11 into 25, because the value of x is 25. So this is equal to 275. Now we are going to find the breadth of the rectangular plot. This is a plot. Okay, rectangular plot. This is a 4x. Okay, the value of x we find here 25. Then it means that 4 into 25, and 4 into 25 is equal to 100. So we find the breadth of the rectangular plot is 100. Okay, so student, I hope all of you understood these questions. Now we are going to discuss next question, question number 7. Okay. In question number 7, the question number 7 hai, the Hassan buys two kinds of cloth materials for school uniforms. Shirt materials that cost is 50 rupees per meter, and trouser materials that cost is 90 rupees per meter. So for every 2 meters, the trouser materials, he buys 3 meter for the shirt materials. Okay, it means that 2 meter, if he bought 2 meter for trouser material, then he buy 3 meter for the shirt materials. Okay, he sells the materials at 12% and 10% respectively. Okay, so his total sale is 36,000 rupees. So how much trouser material did he buy? Okay, here given cost of shirt material is 50 rupees per meter, and the cost of trouser material is 90 rupees per meter. Okay, and here he sells materials, means shirt materials is 12% and trouser materials 10% his sale. Okay, and his total sale is 36,000 rupees. Okay, so how much trouser materials did he buy? So let's see how to solve this question. So for in this question, here the ratio of shirt materials and trouser materials and shirt material is given 3:2. Okay, so we can let the shirt materials and trouser materials be 3x and 2x. So cost of shirt materials is because the shirt material is 3x, and the cost per meter of the shirt material is given here 50 rupees per meter. So total cost of shirt material is 50 into 3x. This is equal to 150x. Okay. Now the selling and he sells the cost material, shirt material is 12% gain, and trouser materials in 10% gain. Okay. So selling price at 12% gain. This is selling price set materials. Selling price of shirt materials at 12% gains. This is equal to 100 plus profit by 100 into CP. So in this way you can find the selling price of shirt materials, and similarly you find the selling price of the trouser materials. If you add them, then this is equal to 36,000, and in this way you find the value of x and put in their supposition, then you obtain the length of trouser materials. No? Okay, so let's see how to do it. Now in this question, first we let, this is question number 7, let shirt material, be x meters. Okay, first we let the shirt material be x meters, 3x, because the ratio of shirt materials and trouser material, this is given 2 meter for every 3 meter shirt. Okay, 2 meter trousers cloth for every 3 meters shirt cloth. So we let here the shirt materials be 3x. Okay, now and the trouser materials be 2x. And trousers material is equal to 2x. Now the cost of shirt materials. Okay, so the cost of shirt materials is cost of per meter of shirt material is 3. Cost of shirt material per meter is equal to 50 rupees. This is given. So total cost of shirt material. This is equal to 50 into 3x. 150x. Okay, now and he obtained selling profit is 12% of shirt material. So we find the selling price at 12% profit or gain. Selling price of shirt material. Selling price of shirt material at 12% profit. This is equal to 100 plus 12% by 100 into CP. What is the CP? Means cost price. Total cost price is 150. This is 150x. Clear? Now you can write it 112 by 100 into 150x. Clear? So if you can simplify this, and then we obtained 160x. 168x. This is the selling price of the shirt material at the 12% gain. Now we are going to find the cost of trouser materials. So the length of trouser material is 2x and the cost per meter of trouser material is 90 rupees. So total cost of trouser material is 90 into 2x. This is equal to 180 rupees. Sorry, 180x. Okay, so now after this we find the selling price at the 10% gain of the trouser materials. Okay, so let's see how to find this. So here we can find the cost of trouser material, CP of trouser material. This is equal to 90 rupees per meter into 2x. This is equal to 180x. Okay, after this you find the selling price of trouser material at 10% profit. Okay, so SP of trouser material, SP of trouser material at 10% profit. This is equal to 100 plus profit is 10% by 100 into a total CP is, here CP is 180x. Okay, so in this way you can see the SP of trouser material is equal to this becomes 110 by 100 into 180. So this is equal to 198. 198x. Okay. This is total cost of total selling price of trouser is 198, and total selling price of shirt materials is 168. But in this question, this is given that the total sale is 36,000 rupees. So if you add the selling price of trouser materials and the selling price of shirt materials, then we obtain 36,000 rupees. Okay, so let's see. Regarding to question, according to question, this is equal to 168x plus 198x. This is equal to 36,000. Okay, now if you add them, 130x and 168x plus 198x, this is equal to 300. Here this is given 36,600 rupees. This is total sale. Okay, now so if you add them, then you obtain 336 is equal to 36,600. Rx is equal to 36,600 by 336 66. This is equal to 100. X is equal to 100. So here you need to find the trouser material is, we'll add the trouser material is 2x, but here the value of x is 100. So trouser material is 2 into x is equal to 2 into 100. This is equal to 200 meters. So now we can write here, trouser material is equal to 2x. This is our superposition, but here we find the value of x is 100. This is equal to 200 meters. Clear? So student, I hope all of you understood in this question. In this question, and the ratio of shirt materials and trouser materials is given 3:2. Okay, this is given that every 2 meter trousers, this he buy 3 meter shirt materials. Okay, and the cost of shirt material is given 50 rupees per meters, and cost of trouser material is also given 90 rupees per meters. In this way you find the value of x according to these questions, and also you find the length of trouser materials. This is equal to 200 meters. So thank you for watching. Jai Hind.